Today is February 4th, 2023. This is my 217th episode for C++ 17 2023 CUDA SQL OpenGL OpenCL DBB Vulkan. This is my 47th episode for vector calculus. 9th episode for surface integral. Surface area with density 2. We will implement new algorithm. If you don't have up-to-date C++ library extensions, then double-click it. Show in folder. Please pay attention to the file name February 4th a.zip extract it if you don't have it. In this folder, you can find up-to-date CPP extension. Copy it on your system drive DEBSoft. Remove existing folder, then paste it with the downloaded one. Now, after filming video, I will upload new library. I assume you have watched two of my previous video listed here. Episode 216 Implement Vector Calculus 46, Episode 215 Motivation Vector Calculus, Episode 45. From this episode, click this link. If you haven't watched my previous video, Episode 216, please watch it, because my current session continues from my previous episode. Thank you, Mr. Kim. You have not only shared your advanced calculus library, but made a video showing the implementation of each part. I cannot imagine the amount of work and resources you have put in to make this possible. Thank you very much for sharing these priceless resources for free. Your efforts are highly appreciated. Thank you, Holiness Weber. You will have unprecedented C++ Calculus Library. Thank for your message, Mr. Holiness Weber. Show more. If you scroll down, you can find download current video source code. Click this link. Show in folder. I downloaded multiple times. Unzip it. Rename 217. Copy the folder path, paste it in your working directory. Now, open up Visual Studio Code. C++ 17 2023 Parallel. From folder 217 Surface, double click surface.cpp. Ctrl V, Ctrl Home. I will copy and paste. After filming video, if you click this link, you can download up-to-date C++ library extensions. Also, if you haven't watched episode 216, 215, please watch them. Otherwise, you cannot understand my current and future sessions. I will copy these links. Copy and fold it up. In our previous episode, episode 15, Motivation Vector Calculus 45, we implemented this function. I will copy from here, scroll down up to this point, copy, Ctrl and paste it here, scroll up. I will rename the function implement 2, copy this function name, Ctrl and paste it here, disable it. We are calling this function. In this function, we defined 3D vector r parameterized with rho and theta. This is 3D vector parameterized using two independent variables. I will clean up like this for easier read. We defined G. G is density. It can be charge density 2, three-dimensional density function. We implemented surface integral. We use this density here. I will explain how to simplify all these processes or how to abstract away all these dirty chores. Open up your command prompt. This is for GNU G++ and Clang. This is for Microsoft compiler. This is for Intel compiler. Because we are implementing library, we have to test. Copy the folder path. CD, we change the folder. Also, CD, we change the folder. CD, we change the folder. I will use Clang compiler first. Dir Clang++ sed C++ 20 surface.cpp ltbb 12 oc.exe clsc. Our function should work like this. Now scroll up. I will copy this. Copy. In our previous episode, in episode 216, we implemented this integral, this surface integral. Right click, go to definition. In the calculus.hpp, we implemented this surface integral. Now arrange side by side. I will copy this. Copy. We implemented this function in our previous episode. I will make it bigger. We also implemented this function in our previous episode. Now copy this. Copy. Paste it here. In this case, if you scroll down, we now have to pass density function. This density function should take three independent variables. So here callable with three floats C or density. Okay, this density is a function that takes three parameters. Now in this part we will create this integrand. Copy, paste it here like this. Da is da, g is this density. Okay, r is a current object. This r represent this r 3d vector that parameterize our surface. With this, our integrand is ready. Sorry, I made a mistake in our previous episode. We should capture by copy. The reason we should capture by copy is that this function can be executed in GPU device in parallel. So try to copy by value. Here also, now we copy integrand here and integrand here. So we implemented this function. Now we will copy this. We implemented this function in our previous episode. Copy here, paste. Scroll up. We need this density as a first argument like this. Then we can pass this density here. In this case, this function We pass density, so we are calling this function. This is done. With this, we now don't need this. Okay, I will simply delete. Then we pass g. Please understand. Sorry. It should be r surface integral. We have to fix like this. I will clean up some code. Delete. I will indent a little bit like this. In this case, surface integral. We pass density. This density is g. Interval 1 is this interval. Interval 2 is this interval. Then integration order. This is integration order. Okay. This function again passes density to this function. So this function generates. This is lambda. I explained it in our previous episode. So it calculates surface integral. Our code is very clean now. With this, we will build again. CLS C. Our function works perfectly. Now, let's move on. In this case, our density function takes 3 parameters. In some case, we can take 2 parameters or constant. So, I will copy this function. Copy, paste it here. I will rename it 3. Copy this function name. Copy, control and paste it here. Now, disable it. Scroll up. I will say G1. This now take rho or theta. It takes 2 parameters. We can say rho times SED ABS SED sine theta. This is our new function. In this case, we take 2 parameters. I will say result 1 G1. I will delete result 1. Copy, paste. Now G2, this is constant. For example, 1.0. Then G2, result 2. In case of G1, it takes 2 parameters. In case of G2, it is constant. What about density function that takes 1 parameter? Please understand, this is surface integral. Surface integral is 2-dimensional. In such case, density that takes 1 parameter does not make sense, because this is double integral. However, constant density is possible. Here, I will make demarcation. Scroll up. We will copy from here up to this point. Copy, paste it here. Scroll up. Now, our density can take either 2 parameters or just plot. So, callable with 2 plots or plot C. Copy, scroll down, also here. Now, scroll up. This part should be fixed because we already computed DA. We don't need R. This G represents either G1 that takes 2 parameters or G2 that is constant density. Here, we can't use this. Here, We don't need this. Delete. Then this G can be constant density, so we can't use this. Instead, CNA evaluate G, we pass rho and theta because G can be constant density too. Now scroll down. Everything is ready. I have changed this part to plots or plot. Now scroll up. We previously defined, in this case, collable with three plots or plot C. This is wrong. If you try this, it complex because of plot. This plot can cause conflict. In this case, it should be 3 plus C. In case of 3 plus C density, we are covering this G. This G takes 3 plus. If you scroll down, in this case, we take 2 plus, collable with 2 plus, or plot. Or plot means constant density. So everything is ready now. We will use Intel compiler ICPX SED C++20 surface.cpp. I will use FNOSQL or i.exe. Hit enter. CLSI. Now it works perfectly. In case of result 1, we are using density function that takes 2 parameters. In case of result 2, we are using constant density. So, both case works perfectly. Now, we can enable this. This function takes 3 parameters. This function, our density takes 3 parameters. So, all should work. DIR, CL, EHSC, SED, C++20, surface.cpp, FE, m.exe, hit enter. CLSM. Now, our function works correctly. In this case, we are using density function that takes 3 parameters. In this case, result 1, we are using density function that takes 2 parameters like this. In this case, our density function is constant like this. Now, with the plain compiler, we have to test with all compilers. CLSG. Now, with the GNU compiler. CLSG. In all compilers, our algorithm works successfully.